No, you want to, okay. He's giving me two free bigger turkey breasts.
So much. Happy birthday.
Hello, I'm Irene. I met you years ago. You are a lovely person. I'm just sorry I didn't
you
get
so
to
loud.
Really spend a lot of time with you because of us living in Europe for so long. But now that we're back, we are making contact and we love you. You are a wonderful person. Thank you so much. And happy birthday.
Hi, this is Francis. Happy 80th birthday. That is a milestone, quite an accomplishment. I'm sure it's going very well on you. God bless you.
Well, happy birthday. May God continue to bless you.
Happy birthday, Irene. What a blessing to have you a part of our lives. You have been such a blessing, teaching us things, doing fun things with us, and we thank God for your longevity. Thank you so much, and many happy birthdays.
Happy birthday, Aunt Irene. Just want to take this time to tell you how much I love and care for you and how much I enjoy spending time with you all, our trips in Connecticut and trips to Philly and spending vacations with you. You know you mean the world to me, and it was a pleasure spending your birthday with you and going to see the butler. Hope you enjoy the rest of your day.
Happy birthday, Aunt Irene. Again, I'm constantly reminded you're the youngest one, so I'm sure you'll have many, many more. God bless you and enjoy this birthday.
Happy birthday, Auntie. 80 years and 80 more. You deserve it.
Hey, Pig. Happy birthday. So, hey, Pig. Look, I got another child. What's your name, child? Say, birthday, Aunt Irene.
Nobody.
Happy birthday, Aunt Irene. You know you're my favorite aunt, right?
Shh, don't tell anybody I said that.
I heard you. Everybody heard you. Don't listen to her. Goodbye, bye.
Happy 80th birthday, Aunt Irene. I hope that we'll get to celebrate many, many more birthdays. 90th, 100th. I'm very happy to be here today. And let's talk about Barack Obama, MSNBC, and C-SPAN.
I mean, if you don't get out of my face with that.
God.
Happy birthday, Aunt Irene.
We love you.
And I still remember when we took you to Maury's house for what celebration was that?
That's the funeral.
Funeral. Yeah. And you said, okay, whatever time y'all want to leave, we gonna leave. We got there, you kept us another extra day.
Happy birthday to you. May you have many, many more. May the Christ child bless you. Happy birthday to you.
Don't you know love you? Yes, I do. Nothing's freedom. Love you.
Maurice's brother. Maurice's brother. Maurice Pee Wee's uncle.
I'm James Parker. I'm just a friend of Maurice's. We live in the same subdivision, so we became real good friends. So.
And I'm Judy Parker, James's wife, and Maurice is my friend, and my co-worker on the Homeowners Association as well.
And we, Bill's wife, from Silver Spring, Irene's good friend from way back in the day.
Way back.
Oh, Bob Bynum, Helen Edwards Bynum, Mom, Irene, my wife, Gloria.
I'm Yvette. Irene is my great aunt. It's my mother's aunt. I'm from Snow Hill, North Carolina.
Snow Hill!
Pastor Bell, I'm married to. I can't get everything straight, but I'm related by marriage.
Hi, I'm Annette Bell. This is my husband. Aunt Irene is my great aunt. My mother is Faye, and I live here in Richmond.
I'm Aletha Bright. Everybody call me Faye. This is my middle name. Mamie and Lonnie Edwards was my parents. And it's my Aunt Irene, and I'm from Snow Hill.
Aletha?
Aletha!
And my grandmother is Thelma Best, and that's my Aunt Irene's sister.
Thelma Best is my mother-in-law, and of course, Aunt Irene is her sister.
See the program because they love the subject so much they want to support every effort of anything that we're involved in. And I just kept repeating myself. And a couple of times that she would call the house, and especially when Bobby and Gloria were here, it almost slipped. Oh, guess what? Bobby and Gloria are here. And that would have just blew the whole thing. She did not expect that they would be here. And then, of course, my uncle and my aunt showed up, and my friends from the community, and my family down in Snow Hill, and people in Browntown, Connecticut, good Florida, good grief, South Carolina, my Lord. So, you know, a lot of love there, a lot of close-knit relationships and things like that, so that's really great. So I want to thank you all again for showing up. We wanted to keep it small, and we did. Thank you very much.
I'm so great while you're at it.
Pray too.
You might as well bless the food. You already told you might as well bless the food.
All right then. Everyone with their bowed heads for a moment.
We're praying.
All right.
Y'all holding hands.
Okay. Here we go. Dear Lord, thank you for such a glorious day, and each and every day that you give us up to this day and the days ahead. Thank you for getting the people who have arrived for this festival. Here safely, and that their return home will be glorious also. Thank you, Lord, for the blessing that you bestowed upon us to have such close friendships and relationships with our family and friends. And thank you, Lord, for giving us a person who in our lives has projected such sincere honesty, such sincere hope, and such sincere spirituality that has rubbed off on each and every one of us. In Jesus Christ's name, amen.
Amen. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Dylan Irene. Happy birthday to
Yes,
in the dream that you had so long ago that lives in all of the hearts of people. Become a reality. I know we will, because our hearts tell us so.
Happy 80th birthday, Aunt Irene. I love you very much. And when I'm making my acceptance speech at the Academy Awards, I will be sure to say that it all started with a birthday video. Here's to you, Aunt Irene.
Somebody asked me that one time, and to describe the type of person that she is, since I've, of course, known her all my life. Well, she's a phenomenal woman who was married to a phenomenal man. This is about Mom. To say something spectacular about her, the words can't describe. Say something spiritual about her. The good Lord has truly blessed me to have her as a mom. Why? Well, her confidence, her energy, her undying love for family and friends, and of course her son and daughter-in-law too. She just has a sense of let go, let God, let everything go. What it's going to happen, it's going to happen. If it's not, it's not. As long as you put out the effort, everything will be okay. So, you know, I was raised with an indelible sense of having good ethics, having good work ethics, being as honest, in my mind, as possible. But at the same time, my mother made sure that I learned a lot of things. Respect for seniors, respect for young people, respect for my peers. And I've tried to maintain that sense of respect over the years. It's hard to believe, though, spiritually, we're all hit with a sense of doubt. But Mom keeps me focused, keeps people in our family focused on the prize. And that is self-awareness, pride in yourself, education. Do the best you can. If you can't do anything else, you know, whatever you try to do in life, you know, be good at it, and no matter what it is. And again, of course, it goes back to respect for people. Well, with the family that we have and the love that we share for each other, it spills over into other people. And you can see that because they like being around us. They like being around her, her church, her church family. Mrs. Suggs this, Mrs. Suggs that. Going to her for advice or her leaning on them to help guide some young soul that may be lost. So you really can't put a word on the type of person that she is, because when you see her operate, you know, it's just, you know, you think all moms are like that. You know, I know many of my aunts were, that's the household that she grew up in. Spiritual, strong, black men and women who were secure and who also were very much a part of family first, and no matter who may have married into it, they had to deal with Edward's sisters and brothers no matter what. You're going to have a little of that blood in you. So it's just something that's the way that carries over to the siblings, my first cousins and my second cousins and my third cousins. Unbelievable how we have managed to stay close over these years. And we have the same thought patterns as our moms and dads had. Keep family close no matter what, you know, because there's nothing like family, especially a family that laughs and a family that loves as hard as we love to love each other. And the sisters and the brothers of Sister Suggs, Irene Suggs, my mom, well, you know, they all touched us in some way, so we're going to miss them all. We're going to miss their pies, their advice, their laughter, their zany attitudes. You know, every family thinks they got the best family, but boy, I tell you, ooh, this family is amazing. And so, to Mom, you know, you're special. You know, to my cousins, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, doesn't matter, go on and on and on to the next generation, you're gonna be special too. So, you know, just maintain that sense of pride and don't allow anyone to say or tell you that family is not important. Family is important and it's the most important thing. And you know, that's what we've gotten from all the Edwards kids, that family is very important, and you'll see why. Done.
Just how much we love you, and I'm sure you would agree, what could fit more perfectly.